Creating EFT payments in Dynamics GP is really relatively easy to do. Electronic funds transfer is built right into Dynamics GP. So let's go through a quick example. First thing I do is look at a vendor. I'm going to enter an invoice for that vendor. We're going to select that invoice to pay, and then we'll generate the EFT file. So let's get started. Let's go to the purchasing area page. And the first thing I want to do is look at my vendor. In the vendor maintenance screen, I can add a new vendor or edit an existing vendor. Let's take a look at an existing vendor I have here. And this is just the standard vendor maintenance screen. Now, to get to the EFT information, what you want to do is you want to go to the address ID and then EFT bank. So here's all the information about my vendor's account that I can send an EFT payment for. So the next thing I want to do is put in a transaction. So let's just put a quick payables transaction in for this particular vendor. Here's the vendor. Put in an invoice number. Put in an amount. You can always check the distributions, make sure it's correct. You can add distributions here if you want to, or you can keep them the same. These are defaulting off the vendor maintenance card. So let's go ahead and post this invoice. The next thing we'll do is create a batch for payment. So I like to go to this window here, edit check batch. We'll enter a new batch ID, we'll call it whatever we want to. What we'll have to do is we'll have to select EFT right here. We'll have to select the checkbook ID from which the payment will be made. We'll save that batch information. As soon as I tab off that, it'll bring up all my open vendors. Let's take a look at this vendor here. And we'll just select this invoice that we just entered. So the next thing I'll do is I could edit this batch, add payments to it, take payments out. But let's just go ahead and process that. And this is an EFT batch, so it knows it's not going to actually print the check out. And I'm going to send a separate remittance, and we'll take a look at that as well. So let's hit process. Then we're going to print out the remittance form, and we'll send it via email. And it'll go back to this screen here. So what we want to do is select post, and we'll hit process. That'll finish up the check batch or the payment batch. The next thing we'll do is generate the EFT file. So go back to the purchasing area page. And other transactions, we'll hit generate EFT file. Look up the checkbook ID, and we'll process these batches. It'll come up with this message here. You can see it's created the file, put it in this location. So let's drill down and take a look at it. And here it is right here. This is the EFT file that you're going to send to your bank. This is based on the format that's set up in Dynamics GP and the information on the vendor card. So let's take a look at the remittance that was generated and sent to the vendor. Here's a remittance right here. Let's take a look at that. We'll pop it open. This is generated by Word, and this is in a PDF format, as you can see here. So this is automatically sent out to the vendors if they have the email information set up on the vendor card. So that's a pretty easy process for EFT processing. We looked up the vendor. We created an invoice for that vendor. We selected that invoice to pay, and then we generated the EFT file.